Have you ever looked at someone eating a ton of food while maintaining a healthy weight and resented them for having a fast metabolism? Well, what if I told you that you can be that person? In this video, I'm gonna tell you how different types of food affect your metabolism and how to eat in order to boost your metabolism to work more efficiently. Let me start by telling you a story about a previous client of ours. His name is Joaquin. When he was first diagnosed with type 2 diabetes, he was shocked and scared. He knew that if he didn't make some big changes fast, his health would just continue to get worse. For most people, diabetes is a progressive disease. He was already overweight and had tingling feet, showing early signs of neuropathy, and he didn't want to develop further health complications.
And I was officially diagnosed as a type 2 diabetic. And I was sent to have my eyes examined, have my feet examined, and you feel like you're shocked, and you say, you know, I really did it this time, and I need to get treatment.
So he set out to learn more about the disease and find ways to change his health. He knew that insulin resistance and being overweight were issues he could tackle with diet. So he started there. He found the Mastering Diabetes program and came to one of our in-person retreats where we taught him how different foods affect metabolism. He saw big and immediate results from making changes to his diet based on what he learned, and I'm very excited to tell you all about that. But first, I want to teach you some of the important information that changed Joaquin's life so that you understand why he experienced these results so quickly. Some people will tell you that weight is about the equation of calories in versus calories out, but it's not that simple. It turns out that it's not enough to just look at how many calories you're consuming. Instead, you need to consider what you're eating, meaning where you get the calories from. Let me give you a hypothetical scenario. Two groups of people eat the exact same amount of calories each day for an extended period of time. One group is eating a plant-based diet and the other is eating something else. During this time, while eating the same amount of calories, but from different foods, those eating a plant-based diet lose more weight than the other group. Is this possible? Well, let me tell you the punchline. That wasn't just a hypothetical scenario. There are many studies documenting that exact scenario. And I'm about to tell you how it works. Metabolism is the process your body goes through to convert what you eat and drink into energy. Your metabolism is influenced by things like your basic metabolic rate, your physical activity, and the thermic effect of food. Your basic metabolic rate, or BMR, is the amount of energy your body uses just to keep you alive doing all those things in the background, like breathing and cell repair. Physical activity is all the things you do, from walking to the bathroom to running a marathon. And the thermic effect of food is the energy you use when you eat and digest food. You probably already know this, but the three macronutrients that make up the food you eat are fat, carbohydrates, and protein. Fat has the lowest thermic effect, meaning your body needs the least amount of energy to use it, because the body usually just takes it in and stores it as fat. Easy peasy. Carbohydrates have a higher thermic effect because your body has to break them down into usable forms, transport them into your cells, and then your body can either use it or store it for later. So your body burns calories just digesting and using it. Protein has the highest thermic effect. Oftentimes, when people learn that protein has the highest thermic effect, they think, oh, I should eat a high protein diet if I want to increase my metabolism and lose weight. And for most people, when they think of a high protein diet, they think of meat and dairy products. And it's true that those foods are high in protein. The issue is that high protein animal foods are often also high in fat. The two travel together. Did you know that most cheese consists of about 80% of its calories coming from fat? Or in a quarter pounder beef burger, about 50% of the calories come from fat, even if it's grass-fed, pasture-raised, organic beef. Even in skinless chicken breast, you have about 20% of calories from fat. And if you're eating the skin, like on wings or drumsticks, then it's back up to almost 50%. Fat slows metabolism more than anything. So the fat content of most meat and dairy products negates some of the effects you were trying to get from the high protein content. When you look at high protein plant foods like beans, lentils, or quinoa, you will find that they have very little fat and contain a lot of carbohydrates in addition to protein. For example, lentils are approximately 30% protein, 70% carbohydrate, and 4% fat. And it turns out that extra carbohydrate is a good thing. We want our protein to come with carbohydrate. Here's why. Your body wants to use protein for other things rather than energy. Protein's primary role in the body is not providing you with energy. It's doing things like rebuilding tissues, synthesizing hormones, and supporting your immune system. Your body prefers to use carbohydrates as energy. Providing energy is carbohydrates' primary purpose. So when you eat a high carbohydrate diet, you allow your body to operate most efficiently, metabolically speaking, because your body uses those carbohydrates for energy and spares the protein to be used for its ideal purposes. So we promote a diet with appropriate amounts of protein, and we recommend focusing on a high carbohydrate, low fat diet, which has been shown to increase the thermic effect of food. But let's make sure to dissect where your brain goes when you hear the words high carbohydrate diet. You know the Krispy Kreme challenge? Don't do it. We're not talking about donuts here. The same issue that happens with animal protein often happens with carbohydrates. Foods like muffins, donuts, and pastries are baked with things like butter and oil that make those foods have a very high fat content, which, as I'll continue to say, slows metabolism and increases insulin resistance for that matter. In addition to this, foods like potatoes or pasta are low in fat on their own, but often get piled with butter, cheese, and other creamy or meaty foods that once again block the health benefits of the base high carbohydrate food. When we talk about high carbohydrate foods, we are talking about whole foods, single ingredient foods that you can grow and harvest in nature. Foods like bananas, mangoes, rice, oats, lentils, chickpeas, and potatoes. You are welcome to prioritize higher protein foods like beans, lentils, and quinoa within that, and doing so will naturally give your body exactly what it needs to function optimally, because those foods are naturally low in fat and high in carbohydrates too. That's one of the beautiful things about the body. It's like an ecosystem in nature where one thing affects everything. Nothing exists in isolation, and therefore everything works in harmony. When you eat a low-fat, high-carbohydrate diet consisting of whole, unprocessed plant foods, you naturally eat a diet that is high in fiber, high in water, high in vitamins and minerals, and lower in saturated fat. All of these factors also positively influence metabolism, and all of those foods help to improve insulin sensitivity. Having better insulin sensitivity, in turn, helps to improve metabolism, because if your body is more efficient at processing and using carbohydrates, they are less likely to get stored as fat, which would slow metabolism. We taught all of this to Joaquin, and he put it into practice immediately. He started eating an abundance of fruits, vegetables, potatoes, rice, and beans. He ate with no restriction as much as he wanted till he was full of these foods. And here's what happened.
You need to know, I had my first appointment 3 months later. And when I walked in, I had lost close to 35 pounds and my blood pressure was down, my sinuses were clear, and my doctor was shocked by the transformation in a short period of time. My blood sugar is normal in the mornings throughout the day. The numbness on my feet went away. I just feel fantastic.
I'm so happy for him, and I still smile watching that clip. And here's the thing I really want you to know and take away from this video. Joaquin isn't unique. I mean, yes, he is a very special person, and I love the guy. But his success was simply his body responding to the food he was eating. Low-fat, high-carbohydrate, plant-based foods increase metabolism and boost insulin sensitivity, period. High-fat foods, especially foods high in saturated or trans fats, animal foods, and processed foods, slow metabolism and lead to the progression of insulin resistance, period. It worked for Joaquin. It worked for me. It's worked for thousands of people who have used our coaching program to guide them. And should you choose to join us in this way of eating, it will work for you too. As with most anything in life, even if it's simple in principle, it can feel difficult to actually put it into practice. Believe me, I've been there and I get it. That's why we develop free resources to help you learn more and make the necessary habit shifts in your life to get your health back into your own hands. If you want a copy of our free foolproof guide for eating, which will help you to adopt a diet that boosts your metabolism and insulin sensitivity at the same time, click the link in the notes below and get a copy. It has 16 pages of expert advice, scientific research, and easy recipes to make food feel easy and empowering.